Hello, welcome to ED Trading. So in this video, I'll be talking about silver assets. So I'll be showing you easy silver strategy for beginners. So I'll be showing you how to trade with silver and how to make money in silver. Number one, I'll be talking about how to set indicators. Number two, knowing the trend of the market and how to trade with this strategy. Number three, how to buy and sell and take profit. Number 3A, using candlesticks to buy and sell a trade. Number 3B, using trend line to buy and sell a trade. Number 4, how to set your stop loss. Number 5, how to exit the market and take profit. Number 5A, using candlesticks to exit the market. Number 5B, using trend line to exit the market. Number 6, checking your risk reward before placing the trade. Number 7, trades to avoid. Number 8, money management. Number 8A, trade only what you can afford to lose. Number 8B, have a fixed percentage. Number 8C, avoid taking too many trades. Number 8D, establish how much you are aiming to profit in a trade. Number 8E, withdraw your profit. So if you are new to this channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button, drop a comment below, and also give this video a thumbs up. Let's go. So I'll be showing you how to set the indicators. First of all, click open new asset. You go to commodities, then you click on silver. Then you go to the chart type, change to candles. You go to the candle time, you change it to 1 hour. Then you go to indicators. You search for moving average. You change this to 8. Change this to WMA. Set it to red. Then you apply. You go to indicators again. You type moving average. You set this to 200. You set it to blue. You leave it at SMA. Then you apply. Then you go to indicators again. You type moving average. You set this to 19. You leave this at SMA. You change the color to white. Then you apply. You go to indicators again. Moving average. You set this to 20. You leave this at SMA. You set this to green. Then you apply. So these are the four moving averages that we'll be using for this strategy. So please make sure you try to be focused so that you can understand this strategy. It's a very profiting strategy that I've been using and it has been working for me. So we are going to be talking about knowing the trend of the market and how to trade with this strategy. So how this strategy works is, anytime you see this red moving average, white moving average, and a green moving average below this blue moving average, all you'll be expecting to do is taking a sell trade. Anytime you see this red moving average, the white moving average, and the green moving average below this blue moving average, all you'll be expecting to do is taking a sell trade. And anytime you see this red moving average the white moving average and the green moving average above this blue moving average, all you'll be expecting to do is taking a buy trade. Anytime you see this red moving average, the white moving average, and the green moving average above this blue moving average, all you'll be expecting to do is taking a buy trade. How do you know the trend of this market? How to determine the trend of this market? What you do before trading? You go to your candle time, you change it to 4 hours to know where the movement of the market is. How to determine the trend of the market before trading? You go to your candle time, you change it to 4 hours to determine the trend of the market. As you can see, after changing it to 4 hours, this is showing us that we are in a downward trend, we are in a downward movement. Then after changing it to 4 hours, and you have already known the movement of the 4 hours candle, then you change it to 8 hours. Change it to 8 hours candle to also know the movement of the market between 8 hours time. So, as you can see, 8 hours is telling us that we are also in a downward trend. So that's how to determine, that's how to know the trend of the market. Anytime before changing and before trading, you change the candle time to 4 hours, especially when you are trading with 1 hour candle. When you are trading with 1 hour candle, so before you trade, you go to the candle time, you change it to 4 hours, you change it to 4 hours, then to determine, to know the trend, the movement of the market, if it's in the uptrend or downtrend. Then you go, after knowing, you go to 8 hours candle, you change it also to know the trend of the market. You can also go to 12 hours and also a daily candle to know and determine the trend of the market for that day. So next we'll be talking about how to buy and sell and how to take profit using this strategy. So we'll be talking about using candlesticks to buy and sell a trade with this strategy. So how to use candlesticks to buy and sell with this strategy. First of all, as I told you, that anytime you see this red moving average, the white moving average, and the green moving average below this blue moving average, all you'll be expecting to do is taking a sell trade. So after this red moving average successfully crosses this blue moving average, you wait for this white and green moving average to successfully cross this blue moving average. After they have immediately they cross this moving average, this blue moving average, then you wait for this candle, you wait for this a candle not to touch this red moving average before you enter a trade. So after this red has successfully crossed, this white and green are successfully crossed, then you wait for this red candle not to touch this red moving average for you selling a trade. So what happened here is, waited for this green and white to cross, then you see you sell immediately here. Why? Because this red candle is no longer touching this red moving average, so you sell immediately. So that's how to take a trade, that's how to enter a trade using candlesticks. So what happened here is, you wait for this red moving average to cross this green and white moving average again, and the candles to cross this green and white moving average. Then when after crossing or going up, at the return of these candles and this red moving average, what you do, you wait for this red to cross. After the candles have successfully crossed, then you sell. So anytime before selling a trade, you wait for these candles to cross, to retrace up, then come back. Then when they are retraced and they cross back again before buying a trade or selling a trade. So what happened here is, see what happened here again, the candles, you wait for the candles to retrace up, then when they are the cross of the candles again, then you wait for this red moving average to cross back, then you wait for these candles not to touch you wait for these candles not to touch this red moving average, then you sell immediately. So when anytime you see this candle, see a movement like this, retrace up to cross the retrace up, crossing this red and this white and green moving average, and a retrace back, then you sell a trade. So these are to sell candlesticks. So I'll be explaining how to buy with candlesticks with this strategy. So how do you buy with candlesticks with this strategy? First, you wait for a movement from downward, a downward movement to cross this blue moving average. You wait for the red moving average, you wait for the white moving average and the green moving average to successfully cross this blue moving average. After they have successfully crossed this blue moving average, then you wait for these candles not to touch this red moving average. You see, you could have entered there, but this white and green has not fully crossed this blue moving average. And as I always tell people, you don't need to rush in your trading. You don't need to rush in entering a trade. You don't need to rush because you don't want to miss the trade and you end up losing your money. You just stay focused and try to be patient before entering a trade. So you have to wait for this green and white to successfully cross this moving average before entering a trade. So after they successfully cross, you now wait for a green candle not to touch any of this moving average, or you wait for a green candle to break this resistance area before buying a trade. So as this green, white and red moving average have successfully crossed, then you wait for this green candle to show up, or you wait for this next green candle to show up before buying a trade. So this is how to buy a trade with this strategy. So next we'll be talking about 3B, using trend lines to buy and sell a trade with this strategy. How do you use trend lines to buy and sell a trade with this strategy? So looking at this chart, after a movement from the top and the red moving average successfully crossed this blue moving average, the white moving average successfully and the green successfully crossed this blue moving average, then you wait for this candle. You wait for these candles. So after the red moving average, the white and the green successfully cross this blue moving average, then the candles, the movement of the candles, then you locate where a green candle, the open of a green candle, a bullish candle, then you draw a trend line at the open of the bullish candle, at the movement upward, then at the break of that trend line, at the break of that trend line, when the candle breaks that trend line, then you sell at the next candle. You can see, you sell at the next candle. You don't sell immediately, you wait for this green to cross, you wait for this white to cross, and you wait for this red to cross. Then you draw a trend line at the open of any green candle you see, you draw a trend line. Then you wait for a bearish candle to break below before selling the trade. You see, you can either enter here or you wait to be sure, then you draw a trend line. Then you wait for this bearish candle to break below this trend line, then you sell. Then you wait for a retracement again upward, the cross, the candles to cross this green, white moving average, then you wait for it to come back again. Then you wait for this movement, anywhere you see a bullish candle start moving back up, then you draw a trend line and wait for a break of bearish candle. You wait for a bearish candle to break the trend line downward. Then either after breaking the trend line, you can enter somewhere here. You can enter somewhere here. You can sell somewhere here. You see, you are in the money. So you wait for the candles again to retrace back up. Then at the cross break of this green and white, at the break of this green and white moving average, you either draw a trend line. Then at the break of that trend line, then you sell. Then you see, you can do that again here. You wait for them to retrace and break. Then at the open of this bullish candle, you draw a trend line. Then at the break of this trend line, this bearish candle breaks, when this bearish candle breaks this trend line, you sell immediately. So that's how to take a trade using trend line. I'll show you how to buy a trade using trend line. So how do you buy a trade using trend line? After this red moving average, the green and white moving average has successfully crossed this blue moving average, all you do, you wait for, you see where the candles, the limit of the candles, they retrace, they went back up, they retraced again, then you draw a trend line at that limit, then you wait for a break of a bullish candle to break this trend line. Then after the break and close of this bullish candle, you either enter immediately, or because you have seen a lot of retracement here, so you are not sure, then what you do, advisable, you wait for this next candle, this candle to close above this trend line, then you wait for this next candle, you enter immediately, and you see you are making a profit. You can also see what happened here. You wait for this, when you see a retracement like this, you draw your trend line at the limit, at the top of the candles, the close of the candles and the open of the candles, then you wait for a bullish candle to break above that trend line, then you enter at the next candle, you're still in the money. So that's how to buy a trade using trend line. So next we'll be talking about how to set your stop loss. So after buying a trade, what you need to do next is how to set your stop loss to limit the risks in your trading. So how do you set your stop loss? So after the cross of this red moving average, the green moving average and the white moving average below this blue moving average, when setting a trade here, after you have entered your trade, to set your stop loss, you go above this green moving average and this white moving average, set your stop loss here above, and so that's how to set your stop loss. Anytime you enter a trade like this, after entering from this position, your stop loss will be here above this moving averages. So you have entered your trade from here, from this position here, where your stop loss will be, your stop loss will be at the top here above this green moving average, the white moving average, and also above, a little bit above these candles, the end, the close of these candles, these bullish candles here. So retracement, if you enter your trade here, your stop loss will be above this green and white moving average, and also above this bullish, a little bit above these candles here. Then if you enter your trade here, your stop loss will be above these candles here, above this green and white moving average, and also above these candles. So I'll be showing you how to take profit. How to take profit. If you have entered your trade, if you have entered your trade here at this position here, how do you take profit? At the open of this bullish candle or at the close of this bearish candle, you look for a trade, you go back and look for a trade anywhere you see this kind of this thing, that anywhere you see that a bullish candle opens there and a bearish candle also stops there, closes there, that's where you draw your trend line. You draw your trend line like this. That's where your take profit is going to be. Anytime you see, you go back to your trade, your previous trade, and look for a position where you see the open of a bullish candle, closes of the close of a bearish candle, and also a lot of movement there, where you see a lot of movement there, that will be your support area. So you set your take profit just a little bit higher, higher than where those candles stops, where the candles, those candles opens, or where those candles stops. So you can see if you set your take profit here, you'll be in the money. Before a retracement will happen, you're already taking your profit and debt to trade. So if you have entered the trade here, the stop loss will be here, and your take profit will be somewhere here, because where you see a movement like this, a lot of movement like this, then you draw your trend line, then you make your you that position will be your take profit. And see, it came up. You're in profit, you're in money. So that is how to set your stop loss, and also a little bit of how to take your profit. So I'll be sharing more lights on how to take profit later on in this video. So now we'll be talking about how to exit the market and take profit. So number 5A will be using candlesticks to exit the market. So I'll be showing you how to use candlesticks to exit the market. Looking at this chart now, after the red moving average, the white moving average, and the green moving average successfully crossed this blue moving average, that shows you are in a downward movement. So how do you use candlesticks to exit the market? When you have entered the trade like this, from here you set your stop loss here, then you wait for a movement to come. Then after a long movement like this, then you see this, you see another bullish candle. All you need to know is you have to exit that trade. At this position, you have to exit the trade, or you wait for a candle to close inside this moving average, inside this red moving average. You wait for a candle to close inside this red moving average, and that will be showing you that, okay, there's a retracement that wants to happen, and you need to exit the market. When you have entered the trade from this position, and you see something like this, a bullish candle, then a bearish candle, then a bullish candle, just like this, set up like this, all you need to do, you need to exit the trade, because it's telling you that a retracement is about to happen, that the bears are weak and the bulls are starting to take momentum, so you need to exit the trade. You see a retracement like this, you entered from here, see a retracement like this, a long bullish candle like this, all you need to do is to exit the market immediately at the close of this bullish candle. You need to exit the market, because sometimes if you hesitate, you'll just be unlucky and the trade will just go back against you. Then you see, anytime you see a bullish candle like this, a bearish candle, also a bullish candle, you need to exit the trade at this position, because the market is telling you now either there will be a retracement, or the bears are already weak and the bulls are starting to take momentum. So next we'll be talking about how to exit the market using candlestick in buy chart. So looking at this chart now, how do you exit the market in buy chart using candlesticks? You wait for a movement. Start entering your trade, you wait for a movement. Then when you see a bearish candle, a bullish candle, and also a bearish candle, you either wait for another movement of a bullish candle to come and close before exiting the trade, or you immediately exit the trade after this candle crosses and closes inside this red moving average. You exit the trade immediately, or you wait for a movement, another bullish candle to open and close before exiting the market. So how do you exit the market in this position? After entering from this position, you wait for a bearish candle to close, before exiting the market. Or in this kind of position, you don't need to take a trade, because the movement is not good. The movement of the candles here, they are not good. And also, you see this is a resistance area. All this area a resistance area. And any moment, you see, when you check your risk reward, you see that your take profit won't be high and your stop loss will be bigger. So you need to source trade, you need to avoid it. We'll be talking about risk reward later on in this video, so stay tuned. So next we'll be talking about 5B, using trend lines to exit the market. So how to use trend lines to exit the market? Looking at this chart now, after entering the trade, you draw a trend line from the open of this candle, and you touch the second bearish candle, then the trend line will go downward. So and when the movement of bearish candles like this has happened, then at the break of this trend line, at the close of this bullish candle above this trend line, all you need to do, you need to exit the market immediately, because we are showing you that the bears are already weak and the bulls are starting to take momentum. So you need to exit the market immediately, withdraw the trend line from the close, the open of these bearish, two bearish candles, like this, touching the open of the two bearish candles, draw it straight. So at the close of a bullish candle above this trend line, you need to exit the market at that position. So I'll be showing you also how to exit the market using trend line in bullish trade. So after entering the market here, you draw a trend line, like this from this position, touching this, you draw a trend line upward. So when a bullish candle closes, open, closes without breaking the trend line, you draw a bullish, you leave this trend line. After a bearish candle closes below, you draw a trend line there. Then at the break, another bullish candle opens and closes inside this trend line. All you need to know now is you have to exit the market at the break of this trend line. You need to exit the market. So that's how to exit the market using trend lines. So now we'll be talking about checking your risk reward before placing a trade. So how to check your risk reward before placing a trade is a very, very important aspect of trading if you want to be successful in your trading. If you want to be a successful trader, you need to know your risk reward before taking a trade. When you see a chart like this, anytime you open a chart, you see a chart like this, you see all this movement. You see, this is the support area. This is the last support area in this candles, in this trend. This is the last support area. So when you see something like this, you don't enter a trade from this position, from any position here, because when you enter a position, let me say you enter a position here, what you'll be expecting now, you know that this trade is going to turn back from here, from this position, is going to move back up, because all these positions are support area. So any trade here, entering any trade here, you won't have a big profit. You won't be expecting a big profit, but your stop loss is going to be very high. You'll be having a big stop loss. Why? Because these candles are so close to this moving averages. So there's a possibility that these candles may trace back up here before coming down. So when you see a position like this, you avoid it, you wait, because your take profit is going to be very small and your stop loss is going to be very big. So you run away from trade like this. Anytime you see a sideways movement like this of candles, you don't enter a trade like this, because the support areas, this is the support area. If you enter a trade from here, there's a possibility that the trade will turn back from here and go upward and hit your stop loss. And your stop loss will be very big, because you don't want it to hit. So you have to avoid, when you see a trade, when you see sideways movement like this, you need to avoid the trade, because this, your take profit will be somewhere here, because all these areas are support area and your stop loss will be very big. Your stop loss below this blue moving average, because if your stop loss had been somewhere here, you would have been taken out. So you avoid taking a trade in this position. So that is how to determine your risk reward. So now we'll be talking about trades to avoid. So what are the trades to avoid? First of all, when you see a sideways movement like this, and your take profit is very close to your resistance area, all these areas are resistance area, your take profit is very close to your resistance area, all you need to do is to avoid before buying a trade. When you see a chart like this, before selling a trade, you check your take profit. if your take profit is so close to your support area or a sideways movement like this, you need to avoid the trade. And another trade you need to avoid is anytime you see a movement of bearish candles below this blue moving average, the red moving average, the white and the green moving average below this blue moving average, you need to avoid buying a trade in this situation. Anytime you see the market crosses this white moving average, the green moving average like this, you need to avoid buying in this position. You don't buy. And anytime you see white moving average, the red moving average and the green average moving average above this blue moving average, and the market is above this blue moving average, you don't sell. You avoid selling in such market. You don't sell. You wait for a buy signal to come, or you wait for a sell signal in this situation. You wait for the market to retrace back up before selling a trade. You don't buy. So next, we'll be talking about money management. Number 8, we'll be talking about money management. Number 8A, trade only what you can afford. So trade only what you can afford. When you want to invest in trading, you don't take the money that you want to use for your house rent. You don't take the money you want to use to pay your house rent. You don't take the money you want to use for your feeding. You don't take the money you want to use for important stocks. You don't invest money that you feel when trading. You avoid investing money that you're going to feel. What you do is, at the end of the month, if you want to invest in trading, you calculate. After doing your calculations of your expenses, then you know this, okay, this is a certain amount I can afford to lose for this month without feeling it, without even showing that I lost any money. So that's the money you invest in your trading, because trading is not guaranteed. It's not a guaranteed stuff to make money. It's just something of 50-50. So you need to be careful. You need to be very careful. Trading is very risky. You don't take your money that you want to use for important stocks to invest in trading. So number 8B, have a fixed percentage. Having a fixed percentage is when you have, for instance, you invested $1,000 in your trading account. Your fixed percentage will be 2% of your account, of your original account. That will be $20. So if you invest $1,000 in your trading account, all you need to know is you'll be trading with 2% of your account, so that to avoid taking much risk and to avoid wiping out your trading account. So number 8C, avoid taking too many trades. When you are placing a trade, have a target. A daily trade, have a target. For instance, if today you want to take 2 trades, you have a target, okay, that these 2 trades, this is the trade I'll be taking today. Because what usually happens is, I've seen a lot of people that they end up making profit, then because of taking too many trades, they lose the whole profit. After calculating their loss for the day, they end up losing all the profit they have made. Like, if, for instance, you took 2 trades and won, and you end up taking 3 extra trades and lose. So you see, you'll be out of the money for that day. So avoid taking too many trades. Take fewer trades, and that'll profit you. With time, you see your profit start increasing, and you'll be profitable. Because when you are just taking too many trades, you'll not be focused. All you'll be doing, all your mind will be on entering, and you will not be focused on calculating and checking and really following your strategy. So to be profitable in this strategy, avoid taking too many trades, just take fewer trades. So 8D, establishing how much you are aiming to profit in a day. So you need to establish how much you are aiming to profit in a day. When you are aiming for 2 trades, so when you are aiming for 50 to 100% in a day, you need to be focused, and after forfeiting your target for that day, you need to be out of the market immediately. Don't say you want to take extra trades. You don't say you want to invest more. So you need to be focused, and this helps you to be focused, because when you have a target, all you do is you
you wait for the right trade to enter, and you wait for your strategy to set up before entering a trade, so you don't just go into taking a trade. And so that's that on that. So 8E, withdraw your profit. You see, most traders, they end up trading and trading and trading and trading, and they end up losing focus without withdrawing your profit, and you end up losing everything. After making some certain amount of money, withdraw your profit, take it and use it and do something else. Take it and use it to enjoy yourself or invest in it in something else aside trading. So after making your profit, try to withdraw your profit and use it for something beneficial to you. So this is all we'll end in this video. So I'll be making more videos on money management, and I'll be making more videos on forex trading and binary trading. Thank you.